Well, g'day everybody. Welcome back to another Affinity photo tutorial. This week I have another edit for you. Again, I'm using one of my own photos here and I am going to make this photo available to you to practice on in the description below. There'll be a link there for you to download this photo and have a practice yourself. So this photo was taken in New Zealand and when I got to the location to take this photo, it had just rained and also I was fairly disappointed to see this boat moored on the end of the jetty. So today we're going to edit this photo, we're going to turn it into a black and white and we're going to remove the boat as well. So as usual, let's get started. So the first thing we're going to do is duplicate the layer with a Command J. So we've got that layer duplicated. And the second thing we're going to do on this picture is we're going to take a selection just of the jetty. So we're going to come up here to our selection brush and we're going to make it a little bit bigger. Now it's a fairly complicated selection, the jetty, so we really do have to take our time with it. And I'll probably just speed up this little bit and come back when I've got most of the jetty selected and we'll have a talk about the selection of the jetty. Okay, so I will be back shortly. Okay, once you've got your jetty selected, I'm going to tell you right now, it's very frustrating. You're going to have to really resize your brush quite a few times using that option key to delete the selection and add the selection with a smaller brush, making sure you're zooming in on the tops of these pylons here. Make sure you get right to the top of them. Go all the way over here, we can see that we've missed this little one here. So making my brush really, really small, just seeing if we can get the top of that pylon a little bit better. Holding my option key here just to fix this one and really small brush to get around the top of it, get the best selection that we can. Okay, Command 0 to zoom out. What we're going to do with this jetty is we're going to make a copy of it with a Command C and a Command V. So just got the jetty here. Going to turn off both of these background images here just so I can see the jetty. Going to invert the selection up here and just grab my erase brush here. I'm going to make the brush fairly big. Just going to go over just to get rid of any little scraggly bits that we may have left over that we may have missed or might be sticking out that are not going to look good in the final image. So just quickly over that, that is good. Let's turn on both of these layers again and now we can get rid of our selection with a Command D. Okay, now we've got rid of that selection, it's time to remove the boat from the picture. Let's turn off the top jetty layer here. We'll just keep that off for now, we'll bring that back in a little bit later. And making sure we're on the background layer here, I'm going to grab my rectangular marquee tool. I'm going to start fairly high up in the mountains here. I'm going to drag down, all the way down, quite a bit of that water, and all the way across here as well, right down. And once we've got our selection, going to copy it with a Command C and a Command V. Now we're on this copy of just this selection here. We can get rid of our marching ants with Command D or Escape. Over here onto the Move tool, drop the opacity to 75% and let's move this across over the boat. And where I'm aiming for is just on the edge of this pylon here on the jetty. So I'm just going to move, I'm just going to keep sight of that little pylon there. And I want to make sure that this water matches as well, just where that water and that light or that wake of the water matches as well. So let's turn the opacity back up for a few seconds. So on our background layer here now, or our selection that we've just made, we're going to add a levels adjustment. Let's clip that levels adjustment just to that selection, so it only affects that selection. We're going to use our white level here, and we're just going to start turning it down until we see it blend in with that water. Too far? Just about there. Just see the color blending in quite nicely. Let's click off that layer. Let's back on the background layer and let's drop the opacity again to about 75% so we can see the boat. Okay, the next thing we're going to do on this layer of our selection is add a mask. So let's come down here to masks and add the mask. over to our paintbrush tool. We want a nice soft brush right down the bottom here, nice and soft. Our color, we want to have black, so I'm going to hit X on my keyboard to switch those colors over to black. On our flow, I want my flow at 10%. Just 10% on the flow. The opacity can stay at 100 and the hardness can stay at 0. Okay, I'm going to make my brush a little bit bigger. Now I'm going to start blending in that background there. So we don't want to see the seams at all on this selection. So we're just going to blend it in. Make sure that we can't see where that selection starts or finishes. And I'm just using my mouse. I'm actually using a mouse to do this. I'm just going back and forth, clicking back and forth to get that selection blended in. So we'll just blend it in there and up off the jetty here. Just keep blending it in. Okay, I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller just for this area here. I'm going to blend that in all the way down. Don't want to see any of those edges at all. So I'm going to make my brush quite small now. Just going to gradually blend that background in as well. Now I'm doing this quite quickly, but we're actually going to hide a lot of this so you won't even see it at all. We'll just get this bit here. We don't want to see the boat. And just double check, make my brush a little bit bigger using my right and left bracket keys. Just making sure that we can't see that edge at all. Okay, back on the background layer, let's bring the opacity all the way up. Okay, we've got rid of the boat, it's disappeared. Let's now turn on our jetty, the selection of the jetty that we made. Let's turn that on. Now we've got our jetty back, the boat has gone. Background's not too bad. One more thing I want to bring back on the jetty. So I'm going to make my brush about this size, come back to the mask layer on our selection here. I'm going to bring those shadows back in on the jetty. Just bring all those shadows back in onto the water. All the way down, it looks pretty good. What we're going to do next is on top of that selection of the water and the back of the mountains, we're going to add a new pixel layer. And on this pixel layer, we're going to add some mist along the bank so we can hide that a little bit. We're going to grab our color picker up here, make sure we're on the pixel layer, grab our color picker. We're going to pick the color of the mist here, which is sort of a gray color, and we're going to activate that color. We're still on our brush. And I'm going to make my brush a little bit bigger. I'm going to turn my flow now back up to 100% and my opacity at 100%. I'm going to start just outside the picture here. Click once. I'm going to hold my shift key down and I'm going to click again. And we're going to put that mist all the way along. I'm going to grab my move tool and I'm going to stretch that down a little bit. Stretch it up a little bit, and then on that pixel layer of our mist, we're going to add a Gaussian blur. On the Gaussian blur, we're just going to turn the radius up until it blurs enough. Just see that blur at the background, and then we're going to turn the opacity down just until we can see the background sort of very lightly. You might add a little bit more Gaussian blur. Thin that out a bit and maybe bring that opacity up a little bit more just so we can see the hint of that in the background here. We can have a play with our mist here down a little bit. Okay, so there we have our picture with our jetty. We've removed the boat, added some mist into the background. I'm just going to stretch that out a little bit. We've got it on the edges there. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to highlight all these layers all the way down to the background. So I'm clicking on the top layer, clicking on this background layer here, coming up here to layers, and I'm going to select merge visible. I'm going to put all those layers into one photo. Before we go any further, I'm going to remove this little sign here, and I am going to use my in painting brush to remove that. We'll just zoom in a little bit. Make our brush a little bit smaller a little bit smaller still, and let's just paint over that little sign there, and let's get rid of that before we go to the develop persona. A little bit smaller again, a few little bits on the edges here. Okay, so we've removed that, so we can Command 0 to get our picture back to the normal size. And on this picture now, we're going to come over here to our develop persona. On the tones, I'm going to make it black and white. Back to our basics. I'm going to come down here to shadows and highlights. I'm going to turn the highlights down and just the shadows a tiny little bit as well. Back up the top here, I'm just going to do a little bit of contrast, a little bit of clarity, and also turn the brightness down a little bit so it gives us that sort of misty, moody photo. So there we go, everybody. That's my photo in Affinity Photo, my lake in New Zealand without the boat. I hope you've enjoyed the tutorial this week. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. And until next time, I'll say to you, stay well, stay safe. I'll see you. My next video.